Ignition sequence start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hello there. My name is John Search, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to this in-series Liftoff concert, inaugurating the 2020 to 2021 virtual season. Whether you're watching this premiere live, in the midst of the season, or even a year from now, welcome to an innovative new approach to everything that is in-series, and to the world's first virtual opera venue, InVision and the Logan Opera House Without Walls. We opened this concert with the overture to Mozart's Magic Flute, performed as it will be to open our final production of this season, Black Flute, marking a reimagining of that musical fantasy and also in-series return to live performance. The first production of this season is A Fairy Queen, a four-episode podcast opera in the style of a classic radio drama, which retells Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream with the music of Henry Purcell, featuring singers, actors, and instrumentalists from all around the globe, and narrated by myself. I'm recording this from my office, the studios of the classical radio station WBJC in Baltimore, one of the many collaborative partners joining in series to make this imaginative season come to life. And now, sit back and enjoy this program of music, friends, conversation, and invention that hints at the season to come. Welcome from the artists, staff, board, and friends of InSeries. We hope you'll come back often and treat InVision as your home within your home for arts experiences which inspire, inform, and invigorate.
Se solleva, oh. What a movie! What a terrible, awful movie! It's a crime what they put on the screen. I can hardly believe what I've seen. Do they think we're a lot of children? It would bore any four-year-old. What drivel, what nonsense, what escapist technicolor twaddle! Trouble in Tahiti, indeed. Trouble in Tahiti, imagine. There she is in her inch or two of sarong, floating, 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 all among the floating flowers. Then she sees him, the handsome American. I must say, he's really a man, 6 feet tall and each foot just incredible. Well, they're madly in love, but there's trouble ahead. There's a legend: if a princess marry white man and rain for that day, then the white man will be sacrificed without delay. Sure enough, on the night of their wedding day, there's a storm like nothing on earth. Tidal waves and siroccos and hurricanes, and to top it all off, a volcano erupts as the natives sing, ah, 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 ah. Olay, they go crazy with the drumming and the chanting and ritual dance, while the lovers sing a ballad of South Sea romance. It's so lovely, I wish I could think of it. Da-da-dee-dum, da-da-dee-da. It was called Island Magic, I think it was. Oh, a beautiful song, I remember it now. Island Magic, where the evening breezes caress us and the stars above seem to bless us. That's Island Magic. Island Magic. Well, in any case, our hero is tied to a tree. Did I mention he's a flyer who got lost at sea? Anyway, all the natives are crazy now, running wild with lances and knives, and they pile up the wood for the sacrifice, and the witch doctor comes, and he sets it on fire, as the natives sing, ah, and at this point comes the good old U.S. Navy, a-singing a song. They come storming down in parachutes a thousand strong. Everything now is cleared up and wonderful. Everyone is happy as pie, and they all do a great rumble version of Island Magic, of course. It's a dazzling sight. With the sleek brown native women dancing with the U.S. Navy boys, and a 100-piece symphony orchestra. Why? Island magic, where the palm trees whisper together, where it's always midsummer weather, that's island magic. Island magic. What a terrible, awful movie. Oh, gosh.
Okay. Envision opera. Let's see. That will be much better. Huh. You can't execute me. I'm too sick to die. I'm infected. Oh, my darling Paquette, she is haunting me yet with a dear souvenir I shall never forget. 'Twas a gift that she got from a seafaring Scot. He believed he received in Shalott from his dame, who was certain it came with a kiss from a Swiss. She'd forgotten his name, but he told her that he had been given it free by a sweet little cheat in Paris. Then a man from Japan, then a Moor from Iran, though the Moor isn't sure how the whole thing began. And the gift, as you see, had a long pedigree, when at last it was passed on to me. Love is sweet, and the custom is sound, for it makes the world go round. I repeat, love is sweet, and the custom is sound, but as I have shown, it's love alone that makes the world go round. Oh. Well, the Moor in the end spent the night with a friend, and the dear souvenir just continued the trend to a young English lord who was stung, they record, by a wasp in a hospital ward. Well, the wasp on the wing had occasion to sting a Milano soprano who brought home the thing to her young paramour, who was rendered impure and forsook her to look for the cure. Thus he happened to pass through Westphalia, alas, where he met with Paquette, and she drank from his glass. I was pleased that could be, when it came back to me, makes us all just a small family. Oh!
That's great.
Oh my gosh, it was so much fun to work on those two silly pieces of music. I had so much fun recording them. Hi everyone. My name is Byron Jones, and my history with the in-series goes back almost 30 years from one of my very first gigs as a professional singer when I moved to Washington, D.C. My other hat that I wear is part of the voice faculty at Shenandoah Conservatory, and we are beyond thrilled to get to partner with the in-series this year as they launch this honestly groundbreaking virtual season. Nobody's doing this. They are so cutting edge, honestly.
It's true. And hello, everybody. My name is Matt Altman. I'm the director of choral activities here at Shenandoah University. And our students are so excited for this collaboration. There aren't many opportunities for students to get to sing right now at this time, especially not in choral ensembles. But this opportunity to collaborate with the in-series in productions this year gives our students not only the opportunity to perform, but to perform at the professional level. And so we couldn't be more thrilled to have this opportunity.
Yeah, it will mean so much, not only to the students, but also to the faculty, the whole community. And the great thing is you out there will be able to enjoy this from wherever you are on the planet by tuning into InVision and joining us in the virtual Opera House.
And so in the meantime, we hope that you'll enjoy this video we made last spring when we were all in lockdown of a song that's very near and dear to us here in the Shenandoah Valley. This is O Shenandoah. Mm.
I am Carla Hubner, and I am the proud founder of the InSeries and also was its artistic director for 36 years until 2018, the end of the 2017-2018 season. And one of the important things about this organization that Timothy has been able to take along and continue to expand is the idea of family. We are a family of artists. And it all started in part because initially we had so few resources, and I felt so strongly that those who came in to help needed to be rewarded by being offered the next opportunity. And as it turned out, there were many. And at the same time, one greets new people. Many of our artists, in fact, have gone on to big careers nationally and even internationally. And therefore, new members come, the years go by, and this year we have the wonderful students from the chorale at the Shenandoah University. And that was partly arranged through Byron Jones, an extraordinary singer whom you heard this evening, and who has been with the InSeries many, many years, since he himself was just in graduate school. And we are so happy to count all these wonderful artists and collaborators. And then the major ingredient is you all, the audience. The many faithful there, people who have been with us since the early 90s, so 30 years now. And so when we say your InSeries, we really mean it. This is your organization, that without you, we wouldn't be here, but also we create knowing that you are there to egg us on, as it were.
This year, we're starting a new recital series made possible by the Billy Rose Foundation and our longtime friendship with Mr. John Wolfsetter. Of all the exciting aspects of this virtual season, the greatest is that we can share music, art, theater with audience all around the world for free. This is a joy and a privilege, and it's possible because of the subscribers to InVision, who are given access to additional content throughout the season, including a monthly recital by one of our many talented artists. I'm excited to join with Carla in inaugurating this season, this series, with a recital to air here on InVision on October 1st. You can subscribe anytime to join us for these concerts. Now, it has been a tradition for the In Series to celebrate the birthday of the artistic director. This is a tradition that has passed down from Carla to Timothy. And under normal circumstances, we would have been gathering this week for a big celebration. But instead, we are here today and we are so happy to celebrate Timothy's coming birthday with a rendition of his favorite song. So, happy birthday, Timothy.
Happy birthday, Timothy! Robert isn't the only Schumann featured on InVision this season. A new film project will explore the incredible songs of Clara Schumann, one of many female composers highlighted in this virtual season. I'm Melissa Dunphy, and I also happen to be a composer and a woman, as well as an amateur archaeologist and podcaster based here in Philadelphia. A few years ago, I wrote a piece called The Gonzales Cantata, and I am so thrilled that In Series has made a film of it for you to enjoy while we're all relying on screens for our fix of the arts. Plus, this work is so perfect for a Washington, D.C. audience. The libretto is taken from the transcripts of Attorney General Alberto Gonzalez's 2007 congressional hearings, and I set them in the style of a Handel oratorio. You may recall in those hearings that Gonzalez used the phrase, "I don't recall," 72 times. Since in the Baroque style, a line of poetry is commonly repeated for depth of meaning, I turned this line into a virtuosic aria for the soprano taking the role of Alberto Gonzalez as she sings the words, "I don't recall," 72 times. Here is soprano Melissa Wimbish, one of InSeries 2020 to 2021 resident artists, to perform this aria.
Decisions about who should or should not be asked to resign.
Project in 2016 with a mission to tell women's stories and expand the reach of opera through film.
Opera film!
We wanted to expand the breadth and depth of the stories told about women in classical music spaces. And we wanted to engage an audience that isn't necessarily going to buy an opera ticket, but will absolutely click play to hear beautiful music while watching stories that feel challenging but honest.
There's an incredible community of women in the opera world, but we often feel disconnected and pitted against one another.
We wanted to create an empowering and collaborative community of artists, one which prioritized not just women's stories, but female creators.
To be honest, it was crazy.
Daring.
Aspirational.
We founded a film company with no background in film.
We did do that.
but we were already in such a rich community of artists in the classical world that it was easy to surround ourselves with inspiration, expertise, and moral support.
And 5 years later, we were oddly prepared for this pandemic.
I refuse to let go of classical music for who knows how long.
We're so happy to have this digital space to continue creating now that things have gotten hard.
Even harder than before.
I don't know what's happening tomorrow.
Or next month.
Or next year.
But we are gonna be here because this is when stories matter.
To escape!
To console. To inspire.
The great thing about the Pleiades Project is that it isn't about me.
Or them. It's about her. And her.
And hopefully, in at least one of these stories, you.
Hello, my name is Nigel Rowe, and I've been performing with the In Series since 2017. They were actually one of the very first theater companies I worked for in DC, so they have a very near and dear place in my heart. Now, I've done zarzuelas, operas, cabaret, you name it, there's a good chance that I've done it with the In Series at some point. Now, I've loved every single production that I've done with the In Series, but my favorite is called Duke Ellington's Neighborhood. Now, what makes it so special is that it is an interactive show for DC public school students to experience that teaches them about music, about the history of DC that they live in every day, and really engages and broadens their imaginations. It is such a wonderful and fun show to be a part of. I always have a blast when I perform it. But of course, with this year being the way that it is, Duke Ellington's Neighborhood has not been able to go on as we would have liked. However, we are so excited to be using this new platform, and thanks to funding from the DC Commission on Arts and Humanities, we will be collaborating with Addicts Adams Walking Tours, as well as the DC Collaborative, to keep bringing that magic, that music, that history, all of it, right here on Envision. We are so excited to be venturing down this new path. I am beyond honored. I'm also so excited to be doing all this new digital theater. And I'm also really excited that I can still connect with the students that come to see the shows, as well as all the adults that come to enjoy the shows as well. So I hope you all enjoy.
Fighting to be free, it doesn't
nothing for me, nah. It shows me how to go with my head up. My eyes ain't looking low, I don't feel fed up. That's how come I see a victory. Believe me, things ain't what they used to be.
Hello there, I'm Paula.
Hello, I'm Ben. We're delighted to be here and to introduce the Orpheus Project to you. We are so excited to be doing this. I've been wanting to do this role for a long time, and also to be able to do it with Paula as well is a real pleasure. We are filming it from home, it's a very personal project, and we are working with people all around the world to make this happen. We are working with our fantastic conductor Simone Luti, who's in Canada. He was in Italy. So we have all these different time zones to work with. And Matthew Altman, who is the chorus master at Shenandoah University. But it really is just astonishing how much gorgeous music there is in it. So yeah. for dramatic, poignant dramatic reasons, and for just joyous music. Yeah.
Im Are thrilled that even though this is such a difficult time for artists everywhere, we're thrilled to be able to make
some art. Work.
Yes. We're able to make some art with people that we really love.
But and for now, we are going to have another piece for you, which is actually...
it's a gift
which is
for
slightly
Tim.
More on the classical realm.
So basically, Tim has... the most amazing musical taste, and I completely agree with him. But one of the problems is that one of the pieces, which he absolutely despises, happens to be a piece that other people absolutely love. So as a birthday gift to Tim, happy birthday!
Oh, music. Music to match the times in which we live. Music to soothe the soul and free the something that starts with F. People need to laugh. But what can I write? What can I write?
Barry, you've got to come out.
Pathetic.
You've got to make us something to eat.
Philistine!
At least make us something to eat.
What care I for food?
Barry!
DuPonte lived for weeks at a time on just saltines and port. When will I cease to be surrounded by such sniveling, something that starts with S?
Can you at least make us something to eat?
Can you at least help me clean up the place?
Never! Never! Did DuPonte care about dust? Housework is for mere mortals. I am a librettist. Music.
Could you at least walk the dog?
What dog?
Oh yeah, I forgot. Well, what's for lunch?
The artist's life has its many ups and downs, the singer, the painter, the poet. Perhaps you recall the poet Rodolfo in Puccini's opera La Bohème? We hope you enjoy the in-series reimagining of selections from that great opera, adapted by lyricist...
Librettist!
Librettist Barry Byrne.
Had one kick since
since they cancel Rigoletto. Just the one quartetto. At this point I'd be happy to sing a bit part in Toledo, even one with Nadia. Every night I will sing at my window to all my neighbors. They don't appreciate it at all in the closet. You go, arriva tuxedo mio. Addio, addio.
Hi, I'm Emily Baltzer. I was the music director for in-series 2019-2020 production of Gabriela Ortiz's Annie Su Sombra and Le Cabaret du Carmen. I've also been the fingers behind this liftoff concert for in-series 2020-2021 virtual season on Envision. As you heard from Elizabeth, this season also includes a new song recital series, 12 vocalists from the DC area and beyond collaborating with a fabulous team of pianists. Though I'm far from DC right now and usually, I'm excited that this virtual format gives me the opportunity to participate as an artist and an audience member. I hope you'll subscribe if you're able and take the opportunity to meet all these exceptional artists.
Hello, friends. If we haven't already met, I'm Timothy Nelson, and it's my great privilege to lead this company, In Series, as its artistic director. Tonight has been a very special evening, representing a taste of what is to come this season, as well as the integrity and ingenuity of your In Series. I want to take a moment to express my deep personal gratitude and our institutional thanks to all those that have made this concert possible. Firstly, our tremendous in-series board of directors, the tireless volunteers who guide this organization, as well as the committed and talented staff of in-series that worked behind the scenes to open our 2020-2021 virtual season of adventure. I also want to thank the many institutional funders and individual donors, both to in-series and InVision, that provide the fuel for our artistic fire. Then there's you, our audiences, who are the reason we do what we do, and are as much a part of this as any one of us. And finally, these artists. As Carla said, we are a family of artists, and more than just that, of deeply talented, soulful, dedicated artists. If you think singing is difficult, and it is beyond measure, imagine what it is to do in front of your phone, all alone in your bedroom or the office of your home, with a little headphone in your ear to hear a backing track. I am so honored, In Series is honored, by the huge offering that these artists have made in this performance tonight. Thank you, my friends. This is a gift of the greatest value. I hope that all of you out there watching will continue to join us for a fabulous season ahead, to support In Series as it paves the way towards optimism and creation again, and to be part of this family. Something deeply important to me is that the art we make this year confronts some of the trials our community is suffering through. This will include a trilogy of film projects dealing with loss and grief. That includes the Gluck Orpheus, which you heard Paula and Ben speak about earlier. It will also include a new work using the music of Richard Wagner, including the final aria of Tristan und Isolde, more commonly known as the Liebestod, or Love Death. Holding the fallen body of her loved one in her arms, Isolde says, "How he smiles, how the eye he opens sweetly. Do you see it, friends? Don't you see it? Brighter and brighter how he shines, illuminated by stars, how he rises high. Don't you see it? How his heart boldly swells, fully and nobly, wells in his breast. How from his lips delightfully, mildly, sweet breath wafts softly. Friends, look, don't you feel and see it? Do I alone hear this melody, which wonderfully and softly, lamenting delight, telling it all, mildly reconciling sounds out of him, invades me, swings upwards, sweetly resonating, rings around me, sounding more clearly, wafting around me. Are these waves or soft billows? Are these billows of delightful fragrances? How they swell, how they soar through me. Shall I breathe them? Shall I listen? Shall I drink, immerse sweetly in the fragrances, melt away in the billowing torrent, in the resonating sound, in the wafting universe of the world breath? Shall I drown, be engulfed, unconscious, supreme delight?"
Mild und leise, wie lächelt, wie das Auge hold eröffnet, seht ihr Freunde, seht ihr's nicht?
Hello again. From the midst of an artistic reaction to another global pandemic, author Tony Kushner's Angel from Angels in America spoke the memorable line, "A great work begins." This is only the beginning of a season at InSeries that seeks to make a world that is more open and more beautiful. It is also a season where all around the world, arts organizations will celebrate the works of a composer who dared to imagine such a world, Ludwig van Beethoven. He only wrote one opera, Fidelio, a work that InSeries memorably mounted, and which contains this unforgettable quartet. Thank you for joining us to launch this 2020 to 2021 virtual season. Tell your friends and come back often to InVision, opera that speaks, theater that streams.
The way I wear my sweats, all baggy at the knee.
Gray hairs replace brunettes.
No, no, they can't take that away from me.
The nightly scary dream that wakes you up at three.
I walk the dog 10 times a day. Tons of vegetables I grow.
And my kitchen is the British baking show.
I weed and mow the grass.
I don't, you all know me.
I watch the season pass.
Ignition sequence start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.